whose name was Milky White. True to her name, the cow was as white as milk. His mother and the boy were happy with the cow giving them milk every day, being their source of living. One fine day, the cow did not live to her name. You know why? She stopped giving milk. So she was no longer Milky White. Her mother was dejected, and she said, "Oh Jack, what are we gonna do? We have no milk." Nothing from the cow. Jack said, he actually squeaked, "Mom, I'll take the cow to the market, sell her, get some money, and we'll be happy." Mother agreed. Jack took the cow through the altar and went to the market. As he was walking down the street, a funny looking man approached him. "Ha ha! Hey Jack!" Jack was surprised. "How did he know my name?" The man said, "Do you know how many beans make five?" Jack smiled. "Two in each hand and one in your mouth." The man was impressed. He smiled. "Yeah, you're right. And these are no longer ordinary beans. You plant them in your backyard, and overnight they will grow into a tall beanstalk that will touch the sky. You wanna trade these magic beans for your cow?" Jack thought for a while. He looked confused. The man said, "Don't worry. If it does not work, I'll give you your cow back and I'll take back my beans. It's a deal." Jack thought for a while again. He said, "Okay." So he gave the cow to the man, took the beans, and happily walked to his home. He gave the beans to his mother. And his mother said, "Jack, you poor boy, somebody made a fool out of you. There is no thing as magic beans. Now we have no cow, no money, and we'll have to remain hungry for the day." Off goes his beans, she threw them out of the window. Jack cried, "No, Mom. I like those beans, they will work." But his mother did not hear. Feeling dejected, Jack went to bed crying. When he woke up the next day, he was surprised to see a very tall beanstalk touching the sky. The beans did work. He felt happy. He thought, "Let me check this out." He climbed up the beanstalk and climbed and climbed and climbed. He was up in the clouds. What he saw was interesting. There was a tall, big house in front of him in the sky. He marched towards the house and saw a table with a lot of food. He was hungry. He ate a few morsels quickly. All of a sudden, he heard some footsteps. He felt scared. He looked around. So a table, he beat in the table. There was a giant, a big giant came in. All of a sudden he shouted, "Fee, fee, fo, foom, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I shall have these bones to grind my bread." Jack was frightened. "This giant is really mean." The giant did not find anybody. He said, there might be nobody here. He quickly ate up all the food that was out there. And he felt sleepy. But before that, he thought he went to the corner of the house. And there was a big harp. Near the harp was a hen. He played the harp and pop! A golden egg was laid by the hen. He played the harp again, another golden egg came from the hen. He kept on doing this, merrily for a few minutes. Then he felt tired, he yawned, and dozed off. Jack was looking at all of this, he thought, "Here is my chance." He went to the harp, took the harp in one hand, took the golden egg on another, and quickly ran out of the house. Because of this, there was some noise, some commotion that happened. The giant woke up by that noise. The giant was angry. "Hey you, stop! I'm gonna catch you and eat you alive!" Jack ran even faster. Giant came after him. Jack went to the beanstalk and started climbing down. The giant also went after him and started climbing down. As Jack was climbing down, he shouted to his mother, "Mother, quickly bring me an axe." The moment he reached to the ground, he took the axe from his mother and flap, he hit the beanstalk. Thudder, shiver, cure, all that was what the giant felt. He gave another chop to the beanstalk and the beanstalk was cut into half. Down fell the giant and broke his crown, and the beanstalk came toppling after. the giant was no more. Jack had a deep sigh of relief. He saw the man next to him, the man who sold him the golden ring. The man told him, "See, I told you these beans would work." Jack said, "Nodded, yes, it did. He turned to his mother. His mother said, "Jack, I'm proud of you. But what have you got over here? You've got a hand and a heart. What do they do?" Jack told his mother, "This is a magical harp. When I play the harp, the hand will lay a golden egg." And he showed her a demo. His mother was happy to look at that. She hugged the child and said, "Jack, you truly are a good son." So my friends, the moral of the story is, no matter what, no matter how the tough situation you are in, be brave like Jack. Seize the opportunity in any situation you are, and you will succeed.